Hello, welcome to Joyous Living Today. I'm Bill Odom.
Hi, and I'm Tammy Odom.
We welcome you to the program today. We want you to get your Bibles out. Again, turn to 1 Corinthians chapter 14. We're going to talk again about the baptism in the Holy Spirit and speaking with other tongues, and want it to be a blessing to you.
Yes.
Now, Tammy, I know you've got a song coming up next, so I want you to enjoy this song as Tammy comes and sings for us.
He's calling you to come back home again. He loves you though you've turned your back on him. So many wasted years, a life of pain, a life of tears. Now come on back to Jesus again. Come on back to Jesus today. Call on Him before it's too late. There's no promise of Jesus today. So many hearts have grown cold today, turning from the Savior, seeking their own way. Blinded in their sin, judgment waits in the end. So come on back to Jesus today. There's no promise of tomorrow in this life of sin and sorrow. So come on back to Jesus today. He's waiting to forgive this life of sin. Jesus today.
Well, praise God. Now, again, we want to get back into our conversation, and our topic has been the baptism in the Holy Spirit with the evidence of speaking with other tongues. And for the last several weeks, we've been talking about the baptism in the Spirit, but we've been doing it from a kind of a slant. The slant is that we're taking arguments about the baptism in the Holy Spirit that some people have said, and we're trying to give you the Word of God so that you can see for yourself and not just go by what somebody else says, but you can take the Word of God and understand what the baptism in the Holy Spirit is about. Now, the reason we're doing it this way, and I'm kind of going in reverse of what I normally do in teaching about the baptism in the Spirit, because there's so many people that are opposed to it and because they don't understand it. And many, I'm not going to say denominations, but I've heard many, many people talk against the baptism in the Spirit, talk against speaking in other tongues, and because they don't understand. And we're not opposed to those people. we are opposed to their view, because we believe that the baptism in the Spirit is one of the most powerful things that you can have, one of the most powerful tools that you can have in your arsenal to combat the devil. Yes. Now, if we're going to end up today on talking about the church in 1 Corinthians chapter 14, talking about how that tongues, when it's describing and talking about tongues, this is not an argument trying to convince you that tongues, that it's supposed to be something that's minimal, something that causes confusion, something that you're not supposed to do, Tammy. Mm-hmm. This, the book, 1 Corinthians chapter 14, is talking about how the church is supposed to function. Again, if you go back in 1 Corinthians 12, verse 6, you'll see that it talks about the operation of the church. And in chapter 14, that's what we're discussing. Now, if you haven't, you know, you may have just tuned in today and you're wondering, well, I would like to have the rest of this teaching. Okay, you can go to our website and absolutely free, you can look up any teaching that we've done since we started this program. You can go to DixieSunshine.org, and again, it's free for you to go there, take a look at any of these programs. If you want to go back and view them again or view them for the first time, you just feel free to do so. We also have the DVD. So if you would like to purchase a DVD, and you may want to keep that for yourself or maybe send it to someone somewhere else in the country, then you can do so, and we have a charge for that, of course. But that charge is so we can promote the gospel. That's what it's all about. So praise God again. We're in 1 Corinthians chapter 14. We've read all the way down through verse number 19. And we're going to again pick up in this area here. I'm going to go back to verse 13. I'm sorry. For wherefore, let him that speaks in an unknown tongue pray that he may interpret. For if I pray in an unknown tongue, my spirit prays, but my understanding is unfruitful. The reason I went back to this today is to let you understand how powerful this is, and it's just a simple verse in the Bible, but it explains so much. You know, John 3:16 is a simple verse in the Bible, but it explains so much. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. Well, this again is one simple verse in the Bible, but it's very powerful. It says, for if I pray in an unknown tongue, my spirit prays, but my understanding is unfruitful. My spirit, again, going back to John 3, the part of me that is born again, the part of me that you can't see, I'm just living in an outer shell. My spirit lives on the inside of this body, and you can't see my spirit. When a person dies and leaves this body, their body is still here. The body, the brain, all that is still here, intact, waiting to be buried, and it will go back to dust. But your spirit, the part of you that lives eternally, is on the inside that you can't see. And when you accept Christ as your Savior, you're born again. You're born from above. The Spirit of God comes in and transforms you and changes you into a new creation. Now, you can live eternally with God by accepting Christ as your Savior, or you would live eternally separated from God. And of course, the Bible teaches that there's a place called hell that people go to that don't accept Christ as their Savior. But you know, even if there weren't a hell, being completely and eternally separated from God, the creator of life, is big, as much punishment as you would ever want to have. So see, we want to be connected with God. But it's when I accept Christ as my Savior, my spirit is born again. And now it says here that when I pray in an unknown tongue, it's my spirit that prays, but my understanding, my mind, my brain is not being able to comprehend what's being said, because I'm talking to a heavenly being. I'm talking to someone that for one thing, I believe when we're speaking in tongues, I believe we've got the devil so confused, he just don't know what to do. So see, that's one good thing about praying in tongues. But also, when you look back up in verse number 2, it says that when we're praying in tongues, when we're praying with our spirit, we're speaking mysteries. We're unfolding the mysteries of God. It's like when, sort of like when you put a jigsaw puzzle together and all of a sudden the pieces just begin to fall in place and you say, wow, this one goes here and this one goes here, and they just begin to fall in place. That's the way it is with the Word of God. We don't have an understanding, naturally speaking, about God's Word. Mm. But as we listen to the Spirit, listen to the Holy Spirit, who moved upon men to write the Bible, then the Holy Spirit moves upon us to understand what was written in the Bible. So now we've got the Spirit of God, we've got our spirit that's born again, and now we've got this ability to pray in other tongues and speak those mysteries that can be revealed to us and cause our mind to become fruitful. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Now we're going to read on, what is it then? I will pray with the Spirit. In other words, I'll pray in tongues. And I will pray with the understanding also. I will sing with the Spirit. And I will sing with the understanding also. Else when you shall bless with the Spirit, how shall he that occupieth the place of the unlearned say amen at the giving of thanks, seeing he understands not what thou sayest? For you verily give thanks well, but the other is not edified. So see, he's saying in verse 13 over here, pray that you interpret if you speak in tongues when you're in an assembly, when you're with other people, when you're in the church. Pray that you interpret when you speak in tongues so that others will be edified and not just yourself. And then he says, you give thanks well. Whatever you do in prayer, when you're praying in tongues, it's a direct communication with the Father God, because we're going to look further in more programs and show you that it says that the Spirit is the one that gives the utterance. The Holy Spirit is giving us what to say. So we're praying the divine, perfect will of God. Every time I pray in tongues, it is the perfect will of God for me to pray that way. But other people are not edified. So therefore, I need to pray in English when I'm in an assembly. If I pray in tongues, thank God, it's okay. There's nothing wrong with it. The Bible says over here in verse number 39, don't forbid people to speak in tongues. Let them speak in tongues. But when you're speaking in tongues, make sure that you're doing it in a way that's not just edifying yourself, but it's edifying the entire body of Christ. And if you don't, and if you don't interpret, and if you don't have an interpreter, someone else who is there, and again, I'm not talking about someone that can understand a foreign language. It's not talking about somebody that speaks Spanish or Chinese or Japanese. This is not that type of interpreter. This is a gift of the Spirit, interpretation of tongues, which the Spirit of God reveals to you as someone else is speaking in tongues. He reveals to you what that person is saying, and it's interpretation. So again, it's not a translation. You're not translating word for word what someone else is saying. You're interpreting what that person is saying, and you're doing it in your language, in your native language, so other people can be edified. Praise God. So then Paul goes on and said, I thank my God I speak with tongues more than you all. Again, we're talking about things that in the past people have used, and they've said these things in opposition to the baptism in the Holy Spirit, opposition to speaking with other tongues, because they don't understand it themselves. And then they take scriptures out of context and begin to say things that it really doesn't say. But then Paul says in verse number 19, in the church, I had rather speak five words with my understanding, that by my voice I might teach others also, than 10,000 words in an unknown tongue. And see, you can take that and just pull that verse out of context and say, see, Paul, he's telling you don't speak in tongues. It's just fruitless to speak in tongues. No, he's not saying that at all. He is encouraging. He says, I thank God I speak in tongues more than you all. Yes. But see, we've got to understand how the context is here. Again, he's talking about the church. Now, I'm going to go on down a little further. He said, and Tammy, this is one thing, and I know everyone has their own testimony of how they received the baptism of the Holy Spirit. I know you have. Mm-hmm. And I was at home when I received the Holy Spirit. I was by myself. And there was just, let me share this, because we're going to get into how to receive the baptism in the Spirit later on. But this is one, in the next few verses, this is what gave me the faith that I needed to receive the Holy Spirit, the baptism, and begin to speak in tongues instantly. I had a question about things. The Bible says that faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. The only way you can receive anything from God is to know what His Word says. And then when knowledge of His Word comes, then faith comes. And when faith comes, which is a gift of God in itself, the Spirit of God actually moves on you to receive and shows you what the Word of God says. And then when that happens, then faith comes alive in your heart, and then you receive from God. I've seen it in when it comes to healing, when it comes to people getting their needs met, when it comes to the devil bothering someone, when it comes to someone just being tormented in their mind, and all of a sudden faith comes. The Word of God comes alive to them. And when the Word comes alive, faith comes in your heart, and then changes are made. You receive everything that the Word of God tells you that you can have, praise God. So I was reading this, and I thought there was a contradiction in the Bible because of what these next words are saying. And I'll go ahead and read it. He says, wherefore tongues, in verse number 22, tongues are for a sign, not to them that believe, but to them that believe not. But prophesying serves not for them that believe not, but for them that believe. In other words, you speak in your native language for those that believe. You speaking in tongues is going to help get somebody in the church. You know, they'll see the tongues part of it, and they'll know it's supernatural, and they'll come in and they'll become a believer. If therefore the whole church be come together into one place and all speak with tongues, and there come in those that are unlearned or unbelievers, will they not say that you are mad? Now go back up here in verse number 22. He said, tongues are for a sign, not to them that believe, but to them that believe not. Tongues is for a sign to them that believe not. Then he says, if somebody comes in that's an unbeliever, will they not say that you are mad if you're speaking in tongues? And I'm saying that's a contradiction. I mean, I'm just baffled. I say, Lord, how could you, right there, how could that be such a contradictory term that you say in one verse that the baptism in the Spirit in tongues is for the unbeliever so that he can come in and be saved. And then right on the next verse, you say that if an unbeliever comes in, he's going to think you're mad if you're speaking in tongues. And I read that over. Tammy, I would go home just about every day, and I would read this, and I say, Lord, I know there's not any contradictions in your word, so I need to know the truth. What is this all about? And one day I came myself. I came home, and I sit down in my recliner, and I got my Bible out, and I started reading the Bible, and I opened it up to this verse here. And then I looked at verse number 23. It says, if therefore the whole church be come together in one place and all speak with tongues. And all of a sudden, the word all, where it says all speak with tongues, that word all looked like it was that big. I mean, and I'm not exaggerating. It seemed like it just magnified like that. And I know what happened. The Spirit of God spoke to me. The Spirit of God revealed to me. He said, and all speak with tongues. He'll say that they're mad. In other words, tongues is a sign for an unbeliever. But if the whole church is there and everybody's speaking in tongues and just, they're just kind of pandemonium going on and everybody's doing it and an unbeliever walks in, they don't know what to think. They probably think they've walked into the twilight zone into another country, and they'll think you're mad and they'll turn around and walk out the door if everybody's doing it. And I'm telling you, Tammy, when that happened, when that word all did like that, I mean, it was just revealed to me then. There's not a contradiction in the Bible. We just have to read it in the right way. We have to read it and let the Spirit of God reveal it to us.
Spiritual understanding. It's not
Amen.
Revealed unless it's revealed by the Spirit.
Amen.
And that's the way the Word of God is. A lot of times it's confusing, or you may be, some people think you're deceived when you don't understand it. And it's just, it has to be spiritually discerned.
That's right. There's nothing wrong. You know, I went for a long time, you know, praying and asking God for this wonderful gift. And you know, it wasn't until I sat down. And of course, now don't get me wrong. It wasn't that one day I just sat down, opened my Bible, and I was drinking a beer in one hand, smoking a cigarette in the other, and watching a TV program in the other, and just decided to open my Bible, and all of a sudden God showed me this. No, that's not the way it worked. I was seeking God.
Yes.
I didn't have anything else going on. I was, every day I was seeking the Word of God. I was searching for what God had for me. And see, then one day as I was doing that, it didn't happen just like that. It didn't happen the first time I read this, or the second time, or the third time. And I can't tell you how many times it was, but one day I went in and sat down, and I read this, and then the Spirit revealed it to me. And when He did, then I got up, I put my Bible down, I remember it like it happened yesterday. And this happened about 25 years ago. I put my Bible down. I walked down the hall. I went in my bedroom. I knelt down beside my bed and instantly, fluently started speaking in other tongues. And I'm telling you, it was the most glorious, marvelous thing that can ever happen. Besides my salvation, besides being born again. And I'm telling you, it just began to flow out of me like a river. And it was just such a wonderful, powerful experience with God. But it happened because faith came. And it happened because I understood the Bible. See, it didn't happen because I was reading magazines and going fishing and watching TV. It happened because I was seeking God, and the Spirit of God came on me, and faith came in my heart, and then I received what God had for me. And see, that's the way anything that you receive from God happens, is when you seek after God, when you go to His Word, and if you keep seeking, keep knocking, keep asking, then God will reveal to you and show you the things that He has for you. Praise God. Mm-hmm. But again, these are things that some people I've heard over the years that they have arguments about because they haven't received the baptism in the Spirit. They haven't spoken in other tongues. And because of that, they begin to find arguments opposing it. But see, my theory is don't find arguments that oppose something that's in the Word of God.
Amen.
Try to find arguments in the Word of God that back up what the Word of God teaches. And see, if you're not receiving those things that the Word of God tells you that you can have, it's not God's fault. Because if He says you can have them, you can have them. I remember in Numbers, I believe it's chapter 22, the children of Israel were commanded to go into the promised land. God said, I've given you this land. It's already
Amen.
Yours.
Amen.
You go in and take possession of it. Yeah. And they sent spies out. And two men came back and said, wow, man, it's a land flowing with milk and honey, just like God said it was. And He said, we're well able. Let's go in and take care of it. Let's go in and take this possession that God's given to us. But 10 of them that went in said, nope, nope, that's not for today. Nope, nope, no, that's not for here. No, that's of the devil. Look at all the giants. If that God was in this, there wouldn't be giants in the land. There wouldn't be any walled cities there. And they talked all the people out of the blessings of God.
Yeah.
And listen, God was upset because He had given them something. He had given them this land. This was a gift. And you know, if you went to a party and gave somebody an expensive, elaborate gift, and they refused it and turned it down and began to criticize it and talk about it, you know, it would upset you. And that's the way it was with God. He said, okay, if you don't want my gift, then go ahead and take what you want then. And they walked around in the wilderness for 40 years and had to stay outside of the blessings of God because they refused to believe and refused to act on what God had given them. So don't pass up this blessing, because this is a blessing. It's a part of the promised land that we have today. You know, back in the old covenant, that was types and shadows of things that are for us today.
Mm-hmm.
And this is one of the things of the promised land, is the baptism in the Spirit with speaking in other tongues that will cause a blessing to come into your life. Mm-hmm. Praise God.
Yes, and they have to accept it by faith. Like salvation, you accept it by faith.
Amen. Amen.
That's the way the gift of the Holy Ghost and speaking in tongues is.
Amen.
And we're running out of time again.
Amen.
We're going to keep continuing this the next few weeks. So anyway, we've got time for you to say a prayer.
Amen. Praise God. And now, if you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, we just want to pray for you today that you accept Him as your Savior. And I'm also, again, going to pray for you about the baptism in the Spirit, that God
yes.
would give you understanding. So if you would, just you don't have to close your eyes, you don't have to bow your head, but you do have to reverence God
yes.
because He is an awesome, mighty God.
Yes.
Heavenly Father, just say this prayer with me. Say, Heavenly Father, I know that I'm a sinner, and I know I need a Savior. And You sent Jesus to save me where I couldn't save myself. Now, right now, I receive Your gift. And right now, I believe by the Spirit of God, I'm going to say this. Those of you that need the baptism in the Spirit who are already born again, I say this to you. You repeat this with me. Say, Heavenly Father, I've received your gift of salvation through the Lord Jesus Christ. Yes. But right now, I receive your gift of the Holy Spirit, a baptism in the Spirit, the evidence of speaking with other tongues. I receive it now in the name of Jesus. And those of you that need salvation, I receive Jesus as my Lord and Savior. Yes. And Father, I believe you raised him from the dead. And I believe I'm saved right now in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise God.
Yes.
Praise God. Yes. So if you prayed that prayer, we want to hear from you. So go to our website, DixieSunshine.org, and please let us know.
Yes.
Praise
and,
God.
And me and Mama have a song up next, and we'll be Bill and I will be right back after this.
Amen.
So long I search for life's meaning, enslaved by the world and my greed. Then the door of my prison was opened by love, for the ransom was paid, was free. I'm free from the fear of tomorrow. I'm free from the guilt of the past. I traded my shackles for a free from the guilt that I carry, from the dull, empty life I'm set free. For when I met Jesus, he made me complete, and he forgot the foolish child I used to be. I'm free from the fear of tomorrow. I'm free from the guilt of the past. Oh, I've traded my shackles for a glorious song. I'm free, praise the Lord, free at last. Oh, I've traded my shackles for a glorious song.
Well, folks, that's the end of the program for today, so be sure and join us again for Joyous Living Today.
Have a blessed week.